Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Now, the Lord has spoken with me in a very mighty way about the glorious meeting that will take place in Kisumu. And that is a continuation of the original conversation when the Lord has continued to give me greater detail of the visitation that will come to Kisumu. Now, in this latest conversation about Kisumu, the Lord Jehovah has spoken with me about healing that will take place there. I see a baby whose eyes, whose eyes will be opened, and a bit of tears also in the eyes, but we will see. And then I see this other, it's a boy, this is a boy, I don't know whether he's 12 or so, between 12 to 15, or he's a boy, I may not know the exact age, around 12 or so, who is able to see also. And there's another that's able to walk for the first time, the crippled baby, the crippled boy. And so that means that many, many blind eyes will open in the meeting in Kisumu at the end of this year. That means the Lord will open many, many blind eyes and blind babies, people whose babies were blind, like the Aaron Kipchirchir of Kaptebengwet, who was healed in Eldoret. Families that are in that situation that baby Aaron Kipchirchir were in are going to be released and set free, because the Lord is going to heal many blind babies. He's going to open their eyes. He's going to create different structures in their eyes, even where medicine had said they cannot see again, or perhaps hope to see, they will be able now to see. And furthermore, the Lord at the same time is saying that many cripples will walk. So in this tremendous, grand, mega, historic revival healing service that will take place in Kisumu, many cripples, from crippled babies to crippled normal boys and girls, children, and crippled adult people, people that had no hope, the Lord is going to heal their crippledness and restore their legs and strengthen their weak legs. Some of them, the legs are thin, I can see, but He will strengthen those legs and they will walk free of charge by the power of the blood of Jesus. God is going to help many cripples to get up, raise them from the soil, that they may walk for the first time in their lives and celebrate the goodness of the power of the blood of Jesus. And secondly, many, many blind eyes will open, blind babies, and many families that are babies that are blind and they are stuck where the hospitals cannot help them anymore. But the Lord is now saying that hope is coming. That hope is coming in the anointing that is in the blood of Jesus. The mighty power of blood of Jesus that was shed at Calvary is now coming to deliver His people, to open the blind eyes of many babies that were blind. They will see. They see their mother for the first time. Many mothers that were blind will see their babies for the first time. And many, many blind people, too many cans for the blind, many wheelchairs abandoned in the meeting. And then the Lord will also stretch and strengthen the shriveled leg, the lame leg. He will pull them, strengthen them, and put them down that they may step again for the glory of our Jesus. I have seen these things already before they come to pass. And they shall come to pass on that day, that December 31st and January 1, all throughout. And even as the Lord releases me from Nairobi to begin movement towards Kisumu, the healing anointing of the Lord will zoom, will go ahead of the men of God and will touch people. People start getting healed in the field even as the meeting has not yet begun. The couples that enter the stadium will start getting healed. There will be a huge celebration of the blood of Jesus. At the same time, the Lord has spoken to me about the lame that will abandon their crutches, and then the deaf and the dumb. The Lord will set them free. Many from the schools of the deaf will come in buses, and the Lord will heal them in batches. This time it is much bigger than the meeting we had in Eldoret 1, Eldoret 2. Eldoret 1 and 2 combined, this is going to be a humongous historic revival healing service. And many, many, many mute deaths are going to be healed. I also see a lot of spinal cord injuries that are going to be restored. People get off the crutches. People get off the stretchers. And they are going to be able to walk again. And many, many people with wounds, the bleeding diseases, the tumors are going to dissolve. All these things, even the spleen, I see kidneys inside that the Lord is going to restore so they don't go back to dialysis. And cancers, HIV will dry up. They will join the pool of HIV that the government doctors have been testing in this country and testing and testing and finding that they have been healed. The Lord is coming to dry up the cancers, the tumors, even those babies whose necks are weak, support the head, the legs are weak, and like ropes and hands. The Lord is going to strengthen them and make another formation of their limbs, because this is the hour when the latter glory of Jehovah is visiting the holy church, the church that has separated from sexual sin, the church that has separated from lies, the church that has separated from deception, the church that has separated from the gospel of money and prosperity, the gospel that tries to sell the blood of Jesus. This is the hour for the humongous promised latter revival in the church. That's why the message that is coming forth from here is a message of return to righteousness, the return to holiness, the embracing of repentance, which is the gospel that Jesus left in the church. Repentance being the turning away from sin and wickedness. And so there is a big revival meeting that has never been seen before coming to Kisumu. And then now, in that conversation yesterday at night, the Lord again in that dream reminded me of the cloud of Jehovah that came down on Kisumu on that 31st of December, the year 2012. The cloud that is still throbbing the church, reviving the church, cleaning the church, directing the church, leading the church, rebuking the church, and preparing the church for the coming of the Messiah. And so these are wonderful times to be a Christian, because these are the days now when the Lord is in people, is living among people, and he says the dwelling of God has now become man. God is now dwelling amongst his people at this hour. But at that time when the Lord showed me in that dream, that cloud in Kisumu, then the voice shouted very, very loud. He screamed. Actually, the Lord literally screamed by voice from heaven. And he said, the cloud of Jehovah, the cloud of Yahweh. I'm giving you the exact words that he said. And so it looks like Kisumu is going to be a very big historic meeting again, like it was at the time of that visitation, and even greater, because I've seen a greater level of healing and people set free, people with hydrocephalus, the Lord will shrink them, the wombs that are blocked, the bleeding diseases, the wounds will dry up, any leukemias in the blood, diabetes, all these conditions, hypertension, the Lord Jehovah, even different heart conditions, people with enlarged hearts, the Lord is going to bring normalcy, make them whole, and restore all manner of diseases under the sun are going to be healed. And so this is the visitation. We are sitting at its brink. We are sitting at the brinks of a major visitation, on the verge of a big visitation in Kisumu. So these are the days of his servant, and these are the days of his glory, and these are the days when the Lord, the power and the authority of the Lord is becoming manifest onto the earth, that man may see and hearken to the voice of the Lord. Again, what I've seen is a huge visitation that will heal a lot of people uncountable. I could see a lot of people trying to get to the altar, many wheelchairs and crutches lifted up, trying to come, people with broken backs with those four-legged aluminium structures trying to get to the altar but could not reach. So let everybody prepare in righteousness and receive their visitation. Again, like I say, nobody knows the hour, neither do they know the day. The day or the hour is not known when the Messiah comes. But when we see these types of visitation come to the church, it speaks very greatly about the hour. It speaks very much about the time, the season we are in, that any moment now the church can go into eternity. And the church that I see the Lord taking is a holy church. I'm talking about a holy church where there is no sexual sin, where the pastors are not lusting at girls and women, where the pastors are not preaching money at all. I see a church that is taken, a church that's glorious, mature, a stable church, a church that's well established in the gospel of righteousness. I see a church that is loved by Jehovah, a mighty church, a church of the kingdom of God. That is the church I see the Lord taking. That is the church I see the Lord taking into his eternity. At the same time, I see a cloud. He shows me this cloud at night, and the Lord yells. He literally yells and says, look, the cloud of Jehovah, the cloud of Mzee. And then I jumped up. I woke up. May the Lord bless all those who have hearkened to the words of Jehovah, that one day they may be counted in heaven as those that heeded the call, heeded the trumpet of the hour, and prepared in righteousness, prepared a glorious garment, a holy garment, and entered into the eternity, the eternal worship of Jehovah. Shalom and shalom.